Take one, take one, take one. This is just a tribute. Alright? It's a tribute to a masterpiece. On every level. Grace to the brute, the technology of the time, this move, the backstory, the moment. The moment. This play right here. This play right here, man. Okay. But the real star here is that camera man. The man who might as well have lost his job for getting too close. He tucked his toes in and delivered the most satisfying slow-mo shot I've ever seen. Okay, won't be too long. But let's just highlight a few points along the way.
He's done a lot of great shots, but I've never seen this before.
Remember, this is an angle they don't even allow anymore because of plays like this. It's ironic that it was another Bulls moment that helped lead to these guys being pushed back a few feet here, too.
They kicked the cameraman.
But back to Bob, since I don't know his name yet. The brilliance of this coverage is fighting the urge. After this narrow miss and perfect coverage, this pan to reveal Bill Cartwright doing literally the only thing this universe would allow, and doing it in all its fundamental perfection. The catch, the plant, the two-hand pass.
Sure, he hit MJ a stride too late.
But we don't have to talk about that. Everything about this pass was already written even way back when. Bill, who MJ couldn't stand. Bill, the same Bill Jordan would launch the ball at in practice to make him look stupid. The same Bill MJ called Medical Bill. The same Bill MJ bitched and moaned about to Phil. It was the same Bill that Phil said had the best fundamentals and footwork in the whole damn game.
Hold on. Okay, I'm talking too much. Just let it ride for a second. Let it ride.
Let it ride. Now back to Duan, because I really don't know his name. The urge he fought was the over-ambitious zoom. I don't even know if this camera and lens was equipped with that function back then. But just in case, he still gets the credit. Our man DeJuan stayed wide and let us capture such staunch fundamentals from Bill, only to lead to the complete spectral opposite in MJ's finish. In this wide, we saw Isaiah give up. And the other Bill overachieved. 99 out of 100 players may just get out of the way of this. But Bill Laimbeer, he put his body and rep on the line and drifted away looking like a goddamn fool. I mean, just look at it. Just let this ride. Let it ride. Now, let's focus in on the plan. MJ, this wasn't improv. He knew what he was going to do. A man who may jump first and think second, in this case, planted. And turned and lifted and lefted and shifted and spinned into the exact spot he planned. It's a playground goof. A move you may do after the whistle is blown. But it's not.
It's not. It's practice. It's prepared.
But let's back up. The save of all saves. How flip-folk graceful is that save? I'm surprised MJ didn't wink right at the camera while doing this. He may have. We were gifted the view of a floating toe knowingly and narrowly avoiding a violation. Listen, my million issues aside, everything in this moment is in his stride. The scope, save, and pass, which in perspective is essentially a warm-up to the actual finish. It's so self-contained. It's enclosed. It's got a cover and a close. The whole damn shot was foretold, or foreshadowed, whatever the saying is. And the details. The details. The flash of the shoes. Somebody tell me what pair they are. This face. This stop and gaze and appreciation. This plant leading to this plant. And how about this ref? Can we talk about the placement of this ref, for God's sake? This clap, the flick. Immediate recognition that our sideline cameraman had the shot for replays. The masterpiece.
This is one for the book, UB.
The masterpiece. Where we feel further and closer than any other shot in Hoops history. It's this convergence of professionals, masters of their crafts, all in unison to deliver an all-time masterpiece. But let's let it ride.
QB. He's done a lot of great shots, but I've never seen this before from him.
I just see him. It's an excellent save. Now, when he gets it back, you'll see him elevate, do a 360, and just toss it up.
He misses the free throw, but the crowd doesn't care. The Bulls are up 8-2, and Michael Jordan has already given them their money's worth.
Because there's always something else to notice, my absolute favorite part about this clip I didn't even mention. So let me show you this. The double character reveal. It's a move that even on a movie set would take practice. First, we got this one off the top where MJ, at the very beginning of this replay, is revealed behind the ref, like he was just back there the whole time. The whole entire being, him and the ball, full speed, revealed behind the ref. Perfect angle. And then again, when we get this full frame wipe from MJ, the ball's already been passed, it's in the air somewhere. He reveals Bill Cartwright in the middle of the court, and that is our second reveal. It's perfect. You don't know where the ball's going, but as he moves, he reveals where the ball's going, and he's already getting set up to pass it right back. So it's crazy, because if you only knew about this play from this particular angle, strictly this angle, it's full of twists and turns and reveals. Literally. It's great. It's a great little mini story. But then even again, on Bill Laimbeer, a guy known for taking people out in the air, what's interesting is, and this was prime Jordan punching years, we don't know. He may have gone for one of those flagrant maneuvers in the air, but because of what Jordan did and the way Jordan planted and spun away from him, Bill Laimbeer really just floated by, not even being able to get his arms out in the assaulting position. So that was an interesting development in this play also. Okay, that's it for all the clip stuff. Stop on by one of my favorite places and visit the Horde of Grandmas. That's what I call the folks over on Patreon, because giving me $3 a month is a very grandmotherly thing to do. Stop by, check it out. I post a lot of stuff there. There's a couple of really fun people there, and everybody's fun over there, but some good discussions, good basketball discussions. Even if you aren't giving money, just go by, because there's some good discussions over there if you really want to overanalyze basketball. Also, check out some links down below somewhere floating around in the depths of the ocean. That's what the comments look like. It's like the ocean. But the description there, check out some links to the Reddit. I've actually posted exclusive Reddit videos before. Also, check out the Learning Channel. It's the second channel for this channel, and it's all about the process. There's some behind the scenes for certain videos I've done, and if you subscribe there and push the notifications, you're gonna see some behind the scenes for this video and behind the scenes from the last video I did. And if you like that stuff, and also I'm gonna do a lot of question Q&A stuff there. So if you have questions, technically speaking or story-wise, that's your place to go. Live there. Also, please hit the notification for this channel, please. Come on. Please. I know I don't bother you that much, so just hit the notification. Come on. And also, because I'm gonna be pushing out more stuff at a rapido pace, at a more rapid pace. So you don't wanna miss it, because they're all connected. You don't wanna miss part of the story. Also, if you see anybody floating around here on the YouTube impersonating this here channel, pretending to be this here channel, feel free to utilize the report, impersonate button, or just ask them why. I'm not trying to ruin anybody's day. Just ask them why and say, please, have a nice day. Really, like, live, let people live. So, all right. Everything evergreen, remember Minute. And if you're not watching this channel, you clearly don't know basketball.